Eleanor is progressing brilliantly. My physical participation in her birth was minimized, of course. It is vital that I am unhindered by nature's crude bias. I will be, above all, her intellectual progenitor, loyal not to her, but to the people she will ultimately save. But I admit, it is with some measure of pride that I review her marks in standard intelligence tests. As an agent of our beliefs, she may surpass even me.
You're a rare old model, son. Alpha Ceres, I believe. Now, Rapture's full of scientific wonderments just like you. And if we can sell them to the world at my price, well, curing your condition ought to be a cakewalk. Once we find Eleanor, the sky's the limit.
I was hired to engineer a park the likes of which no man has seen. Now all I do is watch over it like a grizzled sheepdog. My first line of mechanical puppets made the children here cool with wonder. But Ryan thought my vision was immature. Antiquated, he said. This place could have been something magical. But instead, he turned it into a school. No, a cathedral. Dedicated to himself.
jam dandy. That'll get you in the park. But buying Incinerate's gonna cost Adam. It's a sort of genetic goo that lets you rewrite whatever God gave you. The Little Sisters carry the stuff, as you may recall, so you'll need to locate one. I heard whispering near the El Dorado Lounge. Have a look.
What you want? I ain't dead yet. Listen up! Chopper! Get yourself hit! No fuck-ups this time!
Daddy's home!
Run,
take aim!
On.
Fire!
Just
unbelievable!
Fire.
You think I was slugging
on
you?
No, Messiah!
I cannot hide it!
Welcome to Ryan of the Universe. Insert your ticket now. Have price for $203.
I am Andrew Ryan. Welcome to Ryan Amusements. Please, enjoy the park.
One night while cruising the Atlantic in his steamliner, the Olympian. His sleep interrupted with a singular purpose. Here, he shouts to his crewmen as he wipes sleep from his eyes. Full stop. We begin building here. Refitted for heavy construction, the Olympian returns with a new cargo. A state-of-the-art submersible platform, nicknamed the Sinker. Ferries supplies and workers to the sea floor, fathoms below. After initial supplies have been brought to the sea floor, the platform is permanently moored in the sediment. Massive iron girders are sunk hundreds of feet into the rock and silt. Below the platform, engineers work to overcome obstacles such as diamond hard rock, obstinate sea life, and unexpected damage.
Dutch turns to shit!
Mean. Pure meat.
Heaven!
Oh,
hell!
Seems like everybody's on the go these days. Everybody but you. You still haven't experienced Ryan Industries' new spring line of plasmids. Isn't it about time you got caught up? Evolve today.
We lost another of the Alpha Series protectors today in testing. Somewhere outside the city limits, he simply vanished. For these men, Rapture has no walls. We must find a method of conditioning them against abandonment of the Little Sisters. Something physical, possibly even lethal. The lab aides are starting to call them Big Daddies. Perhaps there's some genius to that. Bonded pairs, connected by a love that kills.
I love the kids in Ms. Englert's third grade class, but boy, I had no idea what I was getting into, volunteering to chaperone this New Year's sleepover party at Ryan Amusement. Donnie, get down off that exhibit, and I told you, spit out that gum! You'll choke! The kids' parents deserve a night off to enjoy New Year's, but I'm at my wit's end. Donnie, I told you!
After the platform is secured, work progresses at an astounding rate. Designed to be the foundation of Rapture, workers toil around the clock to create the metropolis you see today.
Your kind ain't welcome here.
Hello? Come out, you muggles! You bastard! Run!
Life, you did something terrible to somebody. Well, I hope. You have somebody to carry on your family name.
Thank you.
I know the surface, Eleanor. I spent half a lifetime there, in service of the common good. But then, I heard my own words twisted by fat old men squatting over the embers of Hiroshima. Were the modern world a patient in my care, I would diagnose it suicidal. On perhaps that point alone, Andrew Ryan is correct. Rapture is deliverance.
Used to be there was no margin in run of the gift shop. I couldn't hardly sell off this tourist crap for a penny more than the cost of manufacture. Then I met a straight shooter named Sinclair, and he laid a sweet deal on me. Says he's got some hard luck folks down at Popper's Drop could whip up this junk at half the cost I used to pay. Yeah, I had to pick a needle or two out of the shipment's worth. All in all, nobody's the wiser.
Increase the common joy and ease the common pain. Alone, we are nothing. Mere engines of self-interest. Together, we are the family. And through unity, we transcend the self.
I wonder if they missed their mommy.
Someone there?
Leave them at least! Ridiculous!
My lantern's lit!
Until you arrive, Father, I'm trapped here. Smuggling these gifts out is the most I can do to help.
In ethical psychiatry, we must account for...
Eleanor Lamb speaking. Mum says I'm not to play with the other children because they're being raised on a diet of dog-eat-dog. I wanted to see these dog-eaters, so I waited until Mum was gone and went out to find one. And guess what? The dog-eaters wear human skins. It makes them look just like us.
Now that Big Daddy won't bite until you do. But to get to Lil Sis, you gotta put the old boy down for good.
I have a gun, they're dormant. And my vision's so deep, looking in my eyes, and you can see the trouble with me. I have a gun, they're dormant. They are all as good as gold. There's only one thing that's wrong with me. Mr. Butters. Hurry!
Son, you did it. Now, just let her ride on your shoulders and she'll trust you like her own daddy.
He's nicer than...
We're in business. Now, there are corpses all over Rapture, and little Dimples there can sniff out the atom on them. Find one.
Mr. B. Big Sister doesn't like slow pokes. It's this way.
I found one of those children at last. Filthy dress, all alone. I approached her, praying that it was my little girl. But she was gorging herself on blood from a corpse. It wasn't her. I stared, just reeling. And then that skinny, armored freak that took Cindy jumped me, shrieking like an animal. I escaped, but could Cindy have become one of those things? I've got to find her, now more than ever.
Daddy, over there.
She's got a juicy one, but when she starts draining out the atom, the splicers will come running. Be ready before you set her down on that body. Just put her right down on that corpse.
taking Sleepy's back. Go check him on, and we'll need her milk for a while.
Adam, Daddy, here.
That is a child of the family. Not a toy for you to exploit and discard. It is fitting that you expire here. One more forgotten curio in Ryan's shrine to the self.
Here they come. Keep the splicers off her now till she's finished, or they'll never give up the hunt. Now you know the stakes, son. But a plasmid costs a bit more atom yet. Keep it up.
Someone must be on the property.
I think all of the children have finally fallen asleep. And now that the park is all quiet, I can't sleep myself. I guess it's just you and me, Mr. Voice Recorder. You, me, and 1959. I wonder what the new year was. lights are going out. Kids, stay in your sleeping bags. It's gonna be fine.
Come on, exert yourself! Flatten him out!
On the surface, the farmer tills the soil, trading the strength of his arm for a home and lands of his own. But the parasites say no. What was yours is ours. We are a state. We are God. We demand our share.
Hand me that child, now!
The collection.
Give it away.
Lamb is becoming a problem. Woman is a damned collectivist. Here in Rapture, how could the Council fail to see it? Worse, to hide her intent, she gulls these patients of hers into a religious frenzy. A new Kremlin will rise and swallow the Council House before they realize they've been had. I will not have my city swindled by the parasite, whatever its guise. It is time, I think, to call Sinclair.
Stupid piece of...
I've been rationing my supplies ever since the park got cut off from the rest of Rapture. Gotta stay strong. I'm holed up in this workshop, surrounded by those wailing brats, trying to beat their way in. They want my food, my guns. They want it all. But I got a plan. Gotta fix up the transport sub that's been rusting in the maintenance bay. Then I'm gonna get the hell out of this hole. These animals want Rapture? They can have it.
We found it!
I do not hate you, Delta. Indeed, I care for you in equal measure to any other sentient creature. But I cannot sacrifice 1,000 of my children for one rebellious son.
Chief, we've almost got enough Adam now. To get the rest, you'll have to take care of that little sister. There should be one of the air vents they favor in the workshop. Bring her down there.
They missed their mommy.
I just tell her, baby, I want a child. End the discussion. Just like that. Stop trying to speak to me, Lord.
Boy?
Rapture is a paradise of the ego, Eleanor. Under Ryan, the voices of an entire city sing the virtues of greed and pride. But truth, rather, is in the body. Already they grow weary of struggling against one another in fruitless competition. Observe the bent backs, the drawn faces. Ryan promised us more, they seem to say. In what shall we now believe? And Eleanor, it is our task to answer.
The parasite makes nothing for itself. Its only tools are taxes and tithes meant to trick you into offering what it has not earned. In Rapture, we keep what is ours. On the surface, the scientist invests the power of his mind in a single miraculous idea and naturally begins to rise above his fellows. But the parasites say no. Discovery must be regulated, it must be controlled, and finally, surrendered.
Walked in the valley of the shadow of death. Oh, Lord.
An artist strives to frame his ideals in an image, to challenge his audience and make his vision immortal. But the parasites say,
no.
Your art must serve the cause. Your ideals endanger the people.
Little girl, she's helpless.
The shadows won't hide you for long.
You ain't her real dad. Hey, we were just getting started. Come on, gotta disappear.
Lacking its own ingenuity, the parasite fears the visionary. But it cannot plagiarize, it seeks to censor. But it cannot regulate, it seeks to ban. Rapture was founded on an idea, and here they are held inviolate.
Now, Tannenbaum would have you turn that sister human again. You'll get just enough Adam for our purposes, and the girls will likely try to repay you somehow. But Rapture's a high-stakes town, son, and she is a jackpot. You just have to be willing to take it all. You'll harvest more Adam than the price of one plasmid, so the rest is gravy. Think about it. Down here, it's your survival or hers.
Thank you.
I drank for her, drew for her, a lady for her, but where is she already?
I heard the altar saying, true and righteous are your judgments, O Lord.
Well, our tin man had a heart all along. Personally, I call that a liability, but you have enough Adam now. Barely. Head to the Hall of the Future and splice up with Incinerate.
Surface, your parents sought a private life, using their great talents to provide for you. They learned to twist the lies of church and government, believing themselves masters of the system. But the parasite said, no! The child has a duty. He will go to war and die for the nation.
Two weeks since we were trapped in this rotten park. haven't been eating. The children need all the supplies we've got left. Need them more than I do. I don't know what's gonna happen. I can feel myself getting weaker. The children have noticed the condition I'm in, of course. What will happen once I'm gone? I'll be all alone.
I met with Sinclair today of Sinclair Solutions. It's this pseudo-legal firm he set up to take problems Ryan doesn't want to admit he has and make them go away. I can fill 40 front pages of the Tribune with stories about this fella if he wasn't paying me not to. And he's got work for me, right? I ask what, and he flashes me these $1,000 Steinman teeth saying this job will, quote, change history.
Down! Into the other! I deserve respect, aren't you? Just come out! I hate waiting!
Great!
Now I've got to get gone!
Third session today with this amazing limey shrink, Dr. Sophia Lamb. She said that all Ryan's horseshit about always looking out for number one is turning us little guys against each other. And what we need is unity, solidarity. Then, she held up a mirror. Turns out, I wear my hair and mustache just like Ryan. So today, I'm spreading the word about Lamb. And tonight, I'm shaving my whole stupid head.
Unable to provide for itself, the need of the parasite grows, until war is made to justify it. Your parents brought you to Rapture, where you need never fear the parasites again. So you see, there is no place for you on the surface. But you may bring the world to you. If you know someone who belongs in Rapture, write a letter to the Ryan Industries mailroom, and you never know. The next new face might be familiar. I know this facility is vital to the preservation of secrecy in Rapture, but seeing myself transformed into that lurching, waxen nightmare, do children truly respond to this? Still, I spoke to a young man exiting the park after the grand opening, asking him what, if anything, he had learned here. He said his chores didn't seem so bad anymore, as long as Mother wouldn't send him to the surface.
Huh?
Thou art slain! Come on, choppers! Tear this place down!
Jimbo, it'll get you out of that Lonely Hearts Club for good. This scheme works 100% of the time, guaranteed. First, find some Betty and take her to Ryan Amusements. Then, you go to the gift shop, buy her a teddy bear. This is key. I ain't kidding around. Then, you buy her a ticket on Journey to the Surface. As soon as you hit that first scare, bingo! Tunnel. Love.
Welcome to the
So, you would drain the people of their life's blood. Rapture is a body, Delta. I am the voice, and Big Sister is the hand. When Rapture speaks of you, it says only this. Sleep now. Your day is done.
Say, Tom here is having a romantic evening with a gal.
What would impress her more than lighting the fireplace with a snap of your fingers?
Son, not even a big sister can keep you down. Well, come on back and melt the ice and we can say goodbye to this two-bit carny ride.
He's gone. James was the only man I ever loved, and now it's like he never even came to Rapture. He heard me sing at the Limbo Room, came up all bashful. He liked hearing songs about what it's really like to live in this town. I think he's been trying to organize folks against Ryan. And now he's gone, and I'm here, singing Rise, Rapture, Rise. Scared to death they're gonna come for me.
Outstanding, sport. You're proving to be quite a windfall. Now just open the train tunnel from the security booth there, and I'll come out and jump on. I like to look a man in the eye when I give him my word. You and me, kid, we're going places.
I had thought you some golem of Sinclair's, brought here to hold Rapture's arms while he rifles through her pockets. But no, you are aware of your plight. Who, I wonder, would be so cruel to force a mirror on a man with no face?
Lamb was waiting for us. Come out shooting and start the train.
Andrew Ryan, he reckoned the free market was some kind of holy spirit gonna lead us all over the rainbow. And I reckon it's a big fat hooker too dim to spot a wooden nickel. So old Andy went and became his own ghost, and I whittled nickels till I made a mint.
Suspended until he is found. Remember, the enemy is alone. We are the family.